Twitter, Twitter, Twitter. Our dearest Twitter is a part of almost all the controversies taking place on the earth. In today's video, we have come with another worldwide viral video spread across with malicious claim and a propaganda to hurt the sentiment of Tibetan. Hello everyone, I am Shivchitranshi and you are watching me on The Underline. Let's dig in what exactly happened on that day. On February 28, 2023, His Holiness the Dalai Lama, the spiritual father of Tibetans, received around 120 students who had completed a skill training program organized by M3M Foundation. His Holiness received the students at the courtyard of the Sugla Khang complex, often referred to as the Dalai Lama's temple, lies in McLeodganj, Himachal Pradesh, India. After more than 40 days from the event, a short news published on April 8, 2023 and updated the next day, The Times of India, the third largest Indian newspaper, focused on an episode of that meeting through a frame from a video. The Dalai Lama kissed a young boy on the lips at a Buddhist event, asking him to suck my tongue. The Times of India introduced the unspeakable word. For some, this is akin to pedophilia. The issue went viral on social media. Footages appeared all over the world. Accusation and indictment filled the international press. However, there's more than what meets the eyes. The video was first uploaded upon YouTube on 1st April 2023 on the channel of Robert Reed. It was then picked by a Facebook page, Deter Influencer from Child Abuse. Interestingly, the Facebook page was created on April 6th, posted the video and later deleted the page. Upon Twitter, it floated across through fake accounts on April 5th. And gained momentum by April 7. By April 10, the video had crossed around 1 million views. The controversial statement had put the internet on storm with criticism for the leader. The rumor mongers cash in on the opportunity and fuel the fire. The aggression could be deciphered from the tweets. On the other hand, many hateful tweets were also made from Chinese official handles and journalists. When watched in full, that episode appears to be more complex and different from the edited footages that circulated. The incident in itself was a marginal moment of the whole event. It happened openly. It was filmed by cameras and it was broadcasted by microphones in front of an audience of more than 120, which included the mother of a boy. No one in the audience, I repeat, no one in the audience rose in disdain or abandoned the meeting. For 40 days straight, no one talked about the incident. The interaction between His Holiness and the boy was longer than the few incriminated images and footages watched in its fullness. It reveals nothing scandalous or obscene. There were smiles and applauses by both the audience and the mother of the boy. In reality, Dalai Lama was getting playful with the boy. As Tibetan told Vice World News that the meaning of this common expression used to tease and teach children. The correct phrase in Tibetan for this joke is Chi Li Sa, which roughly translates eat my tongue. In an article of BBC, they stated that taking out tongue is a way of greeting in Tibetan culture. The video is a mere propaganda to lift him under the category of pedophilia and an attack on age-old Tibetan culture. The worldwide anti-Dalai Lama campaign that started from April 7, 2023 prompted His Holiness to offer an apology to the child and his family on April 10, 2023. At the same time, we couldn't ignore the fact that how Al Jazeera's 2009 documentary, Dalai Lama, A Devil Within, once again gained limelight. The documentary is, however, no longer available online due to its controversial stance. Keyword like devil monk and murderer slave owner pedophile also came up at the same time. In Tibet, the sole leader of the people is Dalai Lama. And as we already know that China annexed Tibet in 1959 completely. All that China aims for is the cleansing of the Tibetan culture. In the past 60 years, China has tried every nuke and do to merge Tibetans into Chinese culture. Although Buddhism is one of the most followed religions in China, they destroy Buddha statues in Tibet. Tibetans have lost their home grounds and find no ways to go back after the coup. Approx 150,000 refugees migrated to countries like India, Nepal and Bhutan, and now merging into Western countries like Canada, US and UK. China claims and brags about the development done in Tibet. However, in the next few minutes, I am going to rectify it all. Tibetans are not allowed to hang or sell the picture of their spiritual leader, Dalai Lama, in their house or street, respectively. Many people got arrested in case of keeping or caught with a picture of Dalai Lama. The Nationalist of Global Times once said hanging the Dalai Lama's image was the same as displaying Saddam Hussein's image would be for Americans. Coming on the second point, children of Tibet minority getting deprived of their cultural educations from school. Once a UN expert said, "We are very disturbed that in the recent years, the residential school system for Tibetans, children appear to act as a mandatory large-scale program intended to assimilate Tibetans into majority Han's culture, contrary to the international human rights standards. These education systems are diminishing Tibetan language and their history from the syllabus of their textbook. Through this, minority are passing towards the Chinese-framed syllabus and diminishing of their own culture." China's mass labor program in Tibet. According to the report of Reuters, Chinese authorities are sending the rural population of Tibet to military-style training centers where they are given training and turned into factory workers or industry labor. Over 500,000 people were trained as a part of the project in the first 7 months of 2020, which is around 15% of the region's population. From this total, almost 50,000 have been transferred to jobs within Tibet and several thousands have been sent to other parts of China. Many ends up in low-paid work including textile manufacturing, construction and agriculture. After seeing it all, Tibetans are protesting in different parts of the world against the oppression of China and criticism of the Dalai Lama. Cultural, religion and motherland defines the identity of a person and their community. Tibet has been deprived of that recognition for almost 60 years now. Leaders and people in exile are trying to light up the candle of their own culture and provide help to the Tibetans living in Tibet occupied by China. The whole incident was hyped to defame the civilization of Tibet and hit a stroke on US, but the dirty sentiments hurted the feeling of Tibetans. All they seek for is an independence of state, press freedom, tourism, and their legacy to be prolonged for years. Tell me on the comment section what are your views on this Dalai Lama controversy. If you find this video informative enough, please like, share, and subscribe. And do not forget to hit the bell icon.